Hello and welcome to this lecture series on tourism. Today we will learn about and discuss the concept of travel insurance. Travel insurance is insurance that is intended to cover medical expenses, financial default of travel suppliers, and other losses incurred while traveling, either within one's own country or in a foreign country. Insurance is the best way to buy peace of mind during travel, as you are covered for a range of possible circumstances that could go wrong with your travel. You might have all heard of the famous saying popularly known as Murphy's Law: if anything can go wrong, it will. Insurance is a method of deriving psychological satisfaction that in case something does go wrong, you can recover full or part of damages incurred. Practically everything on earth can be insured. For example, in 2006, football player David Beckham insured his legs for £5 million. In 2008, a Dutch winemaker insured his nose for $8 million. We will see the various aspects of travel insurance covered in the following topics: concepts of insurance, origin and a brief history of travel insurance, types of travel insurance, limitations of insurance coverage, major players in the insurance industry in India.
Concept of insurance. Why is insurance needed? You must have all heard of insurance in some context. Vehicle insurance, house insurance, life insurance, and so on. It is basically a form of risk management. Insurance is technically defined as the equitable transfer of risk of a loss from one entity to another in exchange for payment. The transaction involves the insured assuming a guaranteed and known relatively small loss in the form of payment to the insurer, in exchange for the insurer's promise to compensate the insured in case of a financial personal loss. You might think, what can possibly go so wrong during a trip? Well, a lot of things. No matter how well organized your trip is, there is always a risk of something going wrong. For example, you could fall sick or meet with an accident and need medical attention. You could lose your passport or your luggage. You might not be able to make it to the trip for some reason and might have to cancel the flight tickets. Somebody close to you might die while on a trip with you, and you might have a tough time bringing the body back home. Some of these problems are not life-threatening. There are some people who see risks as challenges and relish them. They probably think travel insurance is unnecessary, but if they meet with an accident abroad and end up in a hospital whose rates are exorbitant, that is hardly a situation to enjoy. Also, most people want to believe that their trip will be hassle-free and want to have that psychological comfort, especially when it comes to first-time travelers who are not really adept at handling crisis away from home. They will not know whom to trust. Some people just go into a shock during an emergency. For them, travel insurance becomes necessary to effectively deal with the mishaps. You never know what will happen to you next. As they say, it's better to be safe than sorry. So, when did it all start? Did the concept of insurance in general and travel insurance in specific come into existence only recently? And has it always been in the form that we see today? Origin and brief history of travel insurance. Travel insurance is thought of as a modern form of insurance as it's become especially popular over the last 50 years or so. However, travel insurance has existed in some capacity for almost 150 years. In India, insurance has a deep-rooted history. It finds mention in the writings of Manu, Manusmriti, Yajnavalkya, Dharmashastra, and Kautilya, Arthashastra. The writings talk about pooling of resources that could be redistributed in times of calamities such as fire, flood, epidemics, and famine. Insurance in India has evolved over time, drawing heavily from other countries, England in particular. If you consider insurance primarily as a form of risk management, then early methods of transferring or distributing risk were practiced by Chinese and Babylonian traders as long ago as the 3rd and 2nd millennia BC respectively. Chinese merchants traveling on rivers prone to unpredictable dangers would redistribute their wares across many vessels. In that case, even if one vessel capsized, a merchant wouldn't lose all of his merchandise. This was a clever way of preventing huge losses by distributing the risk. Similarly, the Babylonians developed a system which was recorded in the famous Code of Hammurabi, 1750 BC, and practiced by early Mediterranean sailing merchants. The merchants generally took a loan in order to buy a shipment, but there was always a risk of the shipment being stolen or sinking in the sea. When this happened, the merchant would be left with no merchandise and a huge loan to repay. In order to avoid this, the merchants brought into place a system in which, while taking the loan, they also paid the lender an additional small sum. In return, the lender guaranteed that, in case the merchant doesn't receive the shipment due to above reasons, he would cancel the loan. This way, the merchants were safe. The lender was happy too, because he collected an additional sum from every merchant, which totally amounted to a large sum. But he only had to cancel the loan in the event of an accident, which was rare. This is basically how the current insurance companies work. The groundwork to it was laid by James Bateson. He owned and operated the first modern travel insurance agency in 1864. At the time, travel insurance was almost exclusively a product of the upper class and upper middle class, as few others could afford to travel. Bateson's travel insurance company covered all of the costs associated from theft and other unexpected circumstances. In the 20th century, health insurance coverage was added as an option under many travel insurance policies, and the insurance was adapted to target losses due to missed hotel reservations, cancelled flights, and other travel-specific costs. This made travel insurance a necessary purchase for many businesses and international vacationers, especially as aeroplanes became a more popular form of travel. Over the years, the world has changed, and so have the risks associated with traveling. In accordance, travel insurance coverage too has expanded significantly. Acts of war and terrorism, which were once standard exclusions on travel insurance policies, are now covered by many insurance providers. You have so far learned what travel insurance is, why it is needed, and in what forms it has existed over time. Let us now try to understand the various types of travel insurances that are there today in the market. What exactly is insured? What are the possible scenarios in which travel insurance can be helpful? types of travel insurance. Insurance policies come in a wide range. They could be purchased for one trip of any length or for a specific period of time covering several trips. They usually come in packages which cover several scenarios. For example, trip cancellation coverage reimburses you for prepaid, non-refundable expenses if you need to cancel your trip before you depart. It covers sickness, injury, or death of you, a family member, or a traveling companion. Hurricane damages your destination or cancels your flight. Laid off from work or required to work. Terrorist incident in your destination city. Bankruptcy of your travel supplier. Trip interruption coverage is similar to cancellation coverage, but covers you while you are on your trip for the same list of covered reasons. Medical expense coverage will cover you for accidents and emergency medical and dental care when you travel abroad. Emergency evacuation coverage will pay for emergency evacuation expenses such as airlifts and medically equipped flights back home, and oftentimes will transport you to the hospital of your choice. Baggage coverage can reimburse you for your personal belongings if your luggage is lost, stolen, or damaged. Baggage delay coverage provides money to buy essential items until your delayed bags arrive, such as a toiletry kit, a swimsuit, or another change of clothes. Travel delay coverage provides reimbursement for additional expenses if your flight is delayed, such as an extra night in a hotel or a meal at a restaurant. The 24/7 phone assistance services can help you locate the nearest adequate hospital if needed, organize medical transportation, arrange for treatment and overcome any language barriers, organize transportation home, replace prescriptions in an emergency. In addition to the above, phone assistance services also cover non-medical service assistance, which includes lost baggage search, stolen luggage replacement assistance, lost passport, travel documents assistance, travel information including visa, passport requirements, emergency telephone interpretation assistance. The first telephone interpreting service was developed in Australia in 1973. The 24-hour emergency telephone interpreting service was created by the Department of Immigration in that country, and originally it provided interpreting in 8 languages. Medical emergencies and crimes do not always happen during business hours. Interpreters can be connected to the interlocutors quickly, preventing long waits. It includes coverage such as life insurance coverage for accidental death or dismemberment. Hazardous sports extends the medical coverage to cover activities like scuba. Rental car collision replaces your personal insurance or the rental company policy. Identity theft provides services to help you in the event of identity theft while traveling. So these are the cases in which, if a person has a travel insurance, he can feel safe. But is that all? Does insurance cover all possible mishaps and emergencies? No. Because there are exceptions everywhere. Let us look at these exceptions now. Limitations of insurance coverage. Even though travel insurance covers a wide range of scenarios, there are still certain cases in which it can't be claimed. If the policyholder was aware of a problem but still went ahead with the trip, or if the circumstances are not too severe, then the insurance policy will not reimburse his expenses. These exclusions will be mentioned, probably in fine print, in the policy contract while purchasing the insurance. So, it's important that a person make sure that he or she has read the clauses carefully before signing it. Some cases in which travel insurance doesn't hold are acts of war, local protests. Although terrorism is covered by most policies, acts of war or civil unrest are common policy exclusions. So even if ongoing protests or sporadic outbreaks in international locations might force you to change your plans, most policies won't help. Pre-existing medical conditions. This is a common exclusion in many insurance policies. It refers to any medical condition that has required attention prior to travel or initiation of the policy. So, while traveling, if the person suffers a health problem related to that condition, his treatment may not be covered. Death or illness of a pet. People don't really take this into consideration, but most insurance policies are not sympathetic if the pet falls sick or passes away during a trip. Loss or damage to keys, money, documents, tickets, or credit cards. These items are commonly listed under the exclusions to baggage and personal items coverage. Sports injuries. Many common insurance policies don't cover injuries from certain adventure sports like bungee jumping, paragliding, mountain climbing, or whitewater rafting. It is necessary to take a separate insurance package to cover such activities. Pregnancy and childbirth. Insurance policies specify the conditions under which pregnancy complications or childbirth is covered. If at all, it is important to read the clauses first. Major players in the insurance industry in India. Travel insurance is mostly covered by general insurance companies, which also offer other types of insurance such as life insurance or auto insurance. Some of the major insurance companies in India are Bajaj Allianz General Insurance Company Limited is a joint venture between Bajaj Finserv Limited, recently demerged from Bajaj Auto Limited, and Allianz SC. Allianz SC, on the other hand, is a German multinational financial services company headquartered in Munich, Germany. Its core business and focus is insurance. As of 2010, it was the world's 12th largest financial services group and 23rd largest company, according to a composite measure by Forbes magazine. The four basic insurance plans offered by Bajaj Allianz are individual, family, senior citizen, student. Tata AIG General Insurance Company Limited is again a joint venture company formed by the Tata Group and American International Assurance AIA. The AIA is an insurance company based in Hong Kong. It has offices in Asia-Pacific region including China, Japan, Australia, India, New Zealand and Vietnam. It is ranked number one among the insurance companies in Hong Kong in terms of the number of policies. The Tata AIG company, which started operations in India in January 2001, provides insurance to individuals and corporates. Along with travel, it also offers a range of general insurance products, including insurance for automobile, home, personal accident, and so on. Their three major plans are Travel Guard for overseas travel, assists in loss of passport, flight delays, sickness, medical evacuation, repatriation across the globe, and so on. Student Guard, for students traveling abroad to study, assists in case of health risks, accidents, loss of sponsorship, and also family emergencies back home. Domestic Guard, for travel within India. IFFCO Tokyo General Insurance Company Limited is also a joint venture between the Indian Farmers Fertilizer Cooperative IFFCO and its associates and Japanese insurer Tokyo Marine and Nichido Fire Group. The Japanese company, commonly called Tokyo Marine Nichido, is a property casualty insurance subsidiary of Tokyo Marine Holdings, the largest non-mutual private insurance group in Japan. Tokyo Marine Holdings was formerly known as Milia Group, which underwent a name change in July 2008. Its headquarters are in Marunouchi, Chiyoda, and Tokyo. IFFCO Tokyo began operations in December 2000 with its headquarters in Gurgaon, Haryana. At present, it has 100 offices in India. It offers retail, commercial, and specialty insurance policies such as credit insurance and fine arts insurance for private collectors of art. Their travel insurance policies offer 5 options, all of which cover worldwide travel, but they differ in the coverage amount. Insurance is a huge commercial enterprise and a major part of the financial services industry. There are many other insurance companies in the world and in India. Only a few have been mentioned here. You must now have a fairly good idea about how travel insurance works. Insurance policies can be complex, and some policyholders may not understand all the fees and coverage included in a policy. As a result, people may buy policies on unfavorable terms. Because of this, many countries have enacted detailed statutory and regulatory regimes governing every aspect of the insurance business. In India, the Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority, IRDA, was constituted by an Act of Parliament primarily to protect the interests of the policyholders, to ensure speedy settlement of genuine claims, to prevent insurance frauds and other malpractices, and put in place effective grievance redressal machinery, to bring about optimum amount of self-regulation in day-to-day working of the industry, consistent with the requirements of prudential regulation. In addition, insurance law is practiced in order to deal with the disputes arising out of insurance policies and claims. Let us now do a case study and understand the application of travel insurance to a specific situation. In July 1999, the policyholder booked a cruise for himself and his fiancée from 5th to 20th March 2000 and took out insurance. He signed a declaration relating to him, anyone traveling with him, and anyone else whose health might affect the trip. This stated that no one was waiting for an operation, hospital consultation, or other hospital treatment or investigations. The declaration stated that if there is a change in your medical condition or the medical condition of anyone who the trip depends on, after you take out this insurance but before you travel, and you can no longer agree with the declaration, you must contact the insurance company. We will then tell you if cover can continue. If we cannot continue cover, you can claim for the cost of cancelling your holiday at that time. If you do not tell us about anything we have asked for above, we may not pay your claim. The fiancé's mother was diagnosed with cancer in December 1999. She underwent surgery in January 2000, but was told in February that further treatment would be required. The policyholder cancelled the cruise then and claimed reimbursement under his travel insurance. The insurer settled the claim by paying £250, the cost of cancelling in December 1999. The policyholder sought reimbursement of the full cancellation charge of £1,394 and a complaint was made against the insurer. The declaration imposed two duties of disclosure on the policyholder, the second of which was an extended or continuing duty that applied to the period just over 8 months immediately before departure. The continuing duty of disclosure was both unusual and unduly burdensome. It was not inconceivable that, after a policyholder had notified a change in someone's medical position, the policyholder and insurer might hold conflicting views about whether cancellation was necessary at that stage. The practical effect of the declaration was to make the insurer the sole decider of whether any policyholder should cancel the holiday. This was inherently unfair and a possible contravention of the unfair terms in Consumer Contracts Regulations 1999. There was no reason for the policyholder to have cancelled in December 1999. There is no evidence that he and his fiancée had realized at that time that they should cancel the cruise immediately, even though it was not due to take place for 11 weeks. The insurer was thus wrong in not reimbursing the full expense of cancellation. So, in this case, the complaint of the insured was upheld and the insurer paid the balance of the charges plus interest.
In the end, travel insurance is just like any other insurance and just as important. There are a large number of policies to choose from depending on your destination, the size of your wallet and your preferences. Travel is always filled with dangers. Some people like taking a few risks and some want to completely play it safe. Insurance is just one small way in which you can gain some peace of mind while holidaying abroad. With that, we'll conclude this session. Thank you.